Hi, my name is Melanie Griffin. I am a graduate of the FSU College of Business in 03 with my finance degree, 06 with my MBA, and 06 with my law degree from the FSU College of Law. I'm excited to welcome you to this episode of Mentoring Moments. I've practiced business law for over 13 years and am presently an attorney with the law firm of Shoemaker, Loop & Kendrick in Tampa, Florida. And I'm also the owner of a small business, Spread Your Sunshine, which focuses on keynote speaking, inspirational products, small business consulting, and hosting a podcast / social media show. Today, given all of the mentorship that has been poured into me by the FSU College of Business, I couldn't think of a better topic to talk about for mentoring moments than how to connect with your dream mentor. And for that topic, I have three top strategies to share in our time together. The first one is this: make sure that if you don't hear back from the person that you've identified to mentor you, that you reach out at least three times via two different mediums. And what I mean by that is oftentimes our students and recent graduates will identify someone, say on LinkedIn, that they think would be a great fit to mentor them, and they send them a LinkedIn message. Depending upon the generation of that potential mentor, as well as how busy they are in their career, and if they like social media, they may or may not check their LinkedIn messages, even if they have a LinkedIn profile. And so what will happen is the student or graduate will send the message, not hear back, and mistakenly think that means that the mentor doesn't want to work with them. When in fact, that may actually mean is the mentor hasn't even seen your message because it's not something they use or check. And so instead of getting frustrated and thinking that mentor isn't a good fit to mentor you, what I recommend is reaching out about three times via different mediums over a six-ish week period. And so it might look something like this, that maybe the first time you send them a LinkedIn message, if that's what you choose to do, and you don't hear back, maybe you wait a week or two. This time you might give the person a phone call. And then if you still don't hear back, maybe try emailing the person directly and or emailing their assistant. If you don't personally have the contact information, you more than likely are able to find it via a Google search. If you're connected with a person on LinkedIn, then in the contact information section of their profile, you should be able to find a working email address and or phone number. Oftentimes, a professional website, when you Google for one, and or the civic organizations with which they're involved, which will pop up with their name search and their geographic location, will also show you their email address, phone number, and possibly assistant. And so reaching out in this way will give you the best chance of actually connecting with them because you're going to get on their radar and figure out how that person communicates best. If you still don't hear back from the potential mentor after reaching out a few times via different mediums and always showing respect, what you don't want to do is to point out the fact that the person didn't get back to you right away, of course. Always just start anew and assume that maybe they had something going on with an aging parent, or maybe they're in the middle of something big at work, and just go ahead and show them some grace. But if you don't hear back from them, then what I want you to do is to give your mentor, quote unquote, a vacation. Don't necessarily give up on them forever, but if that person is someone you truly believe can have an impact on your career, then you may want to give them, say, a 6 month or so rest and then start that strategy again. The next thing is that when you reach out to the mentor, be specific about what your request is and tailor your message to them. So for instance, someone who contacts me may say that they are interested in the JD MBA program and want more advice about whether that's a good fit for them and what potential career opportunities will be available to them. So you don't necessarily want to have something lengthy, but at the same time, you don't want to give them a cut and pasted message that's generic and isn't specifically tailored to that mentor and how they can help you. You also, again, want to clue them in to how they can help you and if there's a specific time frame for doing so. For instance, if you have an interview coming up next Tuesday, let the mentor know that while you understand if they're busy, you may not hear back. Your hope is that if they are able to help you, that you hear from them on or before such date so that you are best prepared for your interview, because in this instance, we have an interview question. The last tip that I will share with you during our time today is to always show kindness and pay it forward. For me, I have mentored hundreds of recent graduates and students during my career, and I am always happy to do it and to give back because of all of the investment that has been made in getting me where I am in my career today. The students who take the time, though, to send a handwritten thank you note at some point after our conversation are the ones that make me feel really loved and appreciated. And if they happen to need my mentorship again, they're the first ones in whom I am going to invest. And you'd be surprised the number of students that don't take this advice and the number of recent graduates that don't follow this practice. And I'll spend maybe 30, 45 minutes speaking with them only to have an instance where I never hear from them again. And again, that's fine. There's no judgment. But if I can only count on a handful of hands how many of those recent graduates and students have actually sent me a note, think of how much it means to me to get one and to know how the time that I spent with that student or recent graduate made a positive difference in their life and or career. And so I want you to keep those principles in mind because sometimes students and recent grads, I understand I was there myself, don't necessarily have a large budget for showing gratitude and showing thanks. And you don't need to. The best present you can give your mentor is to, again, tell them how the investment of their time made an impact in your life. If you'd like to get additional mentoring tips, head over to the Spread Your Sunshine website because we have several mentoring articles over there, as well as podcast episodes that will show you additional ways to meaningfully connect with your mentors. In the meantime, I so appreciate you joining me for this episode of the College of Business Mentoring Moments. And these are so awesome. Be sure to tune in next Monday for the next episode. In the meantime, of course, as a triple graduate of Florida State, I have to say this, go Noles. Bye.